Thank you for joining us today on another installment of Frost & Sullivan's exciting podcast series, highlighting key disruptive technologies, growth opportunities, economic trends, new business models, industry convergence, emerging geographies, and much more. I am Bakar Sadiq Agwan, research analyst with Mobility Team, and in this podcast, I will be discussing findings from our recently published company profiling report on Grab. The aim of this podcast is to provide an in-depth analysis of Grab's current operations, its services, regional presence, financials, success factors, and competition, as well as its strategies, acquisition, and partnerships in order to understand and anticipate its future moves. The research will offer readers insight into key company statistics, both historical and current, estimates for critical parameters, and longer-term forecast up to 2028. Grab is a ride-hailing company headquartered in Singapore and is a leading ride-hailing company in Southeast Asia. It offers a technology platform that connects customers with various service providers. Its services include bike and car taxi e-hailing, private car e-hailing, car sharing, ride sharing, car rental, shuttle services, bicycle sharing, food delivery, parcel delivery, and digital payment services. Founded in 2012, the company has now presence in over 225 cities across 8 countries. It was valued at US$11 billion in 2018 and has raised a total sum of US$6.1 billion in funding at the time of its last valuation. The company is backed by over 30 investors, including venture capitalists, automakers, tech companies, and online to offline service providers. Among leading investors in Grab are Japanese multinational conglomerate SoftBank, Chinese ride-hailing giant Didi Chuxing, and Toyota Motor Corporation. Grab presently has more than 1 million drivers on its network and averages 2.5 million rides daily. It targets a wide range of ride-hailing customers through B2C, B2B, and P2P business models. The company has emerged as the leading market player in the region post its acquisition of Uber's Southeast Asia business in March 2018. The lack of proper public transport infrastructure in many of the countries in which it operates has remained a major factor in Grab's success. Company's growth has also been bolstered by growing number of internet users and increased smartphone penetration across the region. Grab has strong local government support across Southeast Asia because of the help it has provided in terms of variety of solutions related to crucial transportation sector issues, including combating traffic congestion, improving passenger safety, providing real-time traffic data, and supporting driver training initiative. Grab has created business and employment opportunities for a large number of local merchants and drivers, giving it a better brand visibility in the Southeast Asia region. Frost & Sullivan expects Grab to emerge as a super app in Southeast Asia region with a wide range of services on its platform. The company will diversify its revenue stream by exploring new businesses in the digital space. Payment services and e-hailing are anticipated to emerge as core business of the company. With the increased capability and government support, Grab is expected to offer first-to-last mile connectivity and point-to-point travel across Southeast Asia. On that note, I hope you have enjoyed this session. Please join us for future podcasts and become a member of Frost & Sullivan's Leadership Council by emailing us at digital@frost.com. Thank you for your time.